from a long line of potters, stone cutters. I come from a long line of oil pressers, spice makers, so I feel I have the perfect marriage. You see, my family and I, we press the oil, make the spices, and my brother, with my husband and his brothers and sisters, they make the vessels for the good of it. Perfect marriage. My spices are legendary in the village of Bethany. Actually, all of my cooking is. Now, I'm not bragging. I just want you to understand why Simon's wife always asks me to help her whenever she's doing cooking for a big group of people. Well, this time she was doing a dinner for Jesus and all of his disciples. Now, between us, it's a big job putting on a dinner for Jesus and all of his disciples. But we don't mind. Because every time Jesus comes to the village of Bethany, we all benefit from his life-giving words, his healing touch, his transforming presence. Anyway, back to the dinner. I was standing in the doorway of the kitchen, and I was looking out into the hall. We had it decorated so beautifully. And people they were enjoying the food, having a good time. And all of a sudden, Mary, the sister of Martha and Lazarus, she began walking toward Jesus, who was reclining at table. She removed her hair brooch, took off her hair veil, and let her long hair fall about her shoulders, loose in public. In the other hand, she had a vessel like this. Then she knelt down in front of Jesus, poured oil on his feet, and wiped the oil away with her. Oh, you sound as shocked as we were. We didn't know what to think. I motioned to Martha. You know where Martha was. Where was Martha? In the kitchen, helping. So I motioned to Martha to come and stand and look to see what her sister was doing. There was an eternity of silence. Lazarus sat at the table with Jesus, who sat like a statue and didn't move. Jesus smiled gently at Mary as she offered him this gift of homage. No one breathed. It was completely silence until finally Judas broke the silence.